Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I'm so excited because Ricky asked me to tell the story, tell a story, and so I'm like, oh, pretty, finally I get to tell the story. Because I read it and I just love it. I love the story. And my Bible verse that I chose, it was hard to choose one, but it's from Psalm, and Psalm 91, verses 3 and 4. Surely he will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. Okay. All right. Maybe some of you know this story, but Iram and his wife, Christiana, first met Ellen White in Australia. And Iram was her farmhand and her farm manager. And he worked very, very hard, and he was a good worker. And so when Ellen White and her family moved back, oh, he also helped build a school there in Australia. And when Ellen White later moved back to the United States, she was so impressed by Iram that she wrote him a letter and asked him if he would bring his family and come and help her in the United States. And even though Iram was a hard worker and a good farm manager, but Iram had not two, not four, not six children, he had 13. 13 children, and how many is that all together with Iram and Christiana and 13 growing boys and girls? 15. 15 people around that dining room table that he had to feed. And so this one particular Sabbath, everyone in the family was looking so forward to having this wonderful dish of stewed mushrooms. And the kids had all helped collect the mushrooms, and I don't know if you've ever had mushroom picking, have you, Brianna? No? Well, there's a lot of different kinds of mushrooms, and you have to know which ones you're picking. But anyways, they all helped, and they collected all these mushrooms, and they could smell Mom cooking all of these, this wonderful stew, and they were so excited, and they couldn't wait for Sabbath to church to get over it, because they were going to go home and have this wonderful mushroom stew. They had trouble even concentrating during the sermon, because they were thinking about that delicious mushroom stew. And so finally church was over and they're all gathered around the table, all 15 of them. I can't even imagine 13 children. Anyways, there must have been a big pot of stew. So they were all gathered around the table. And they all closed their eyes and Father Iram asked the blessing on the food. And then it happened. It was so sudden and unexpected that some of the girls screamed. It was dark in that room, so they lit an oil lamp that was hanging above the table. And all of a sudden, that oil lamp shattered. And there was glass everywhere, all over the stew, all over the table. It was a huge mess. And nobody was hurt, but they were not very happy. Quite upset. And the children were like, why? We prayed, we asked God to bless the food. Why did he let this happen to our stew? And so Mom and the kids started cleaning up all the glass. And Father Iram started going through the stew, picking out the big pieces of glass, thinking maybe he could salvage some of the stew. And as he's going through the stew, he saw it. A poisonous mushroom. It was a deadly poison mushroom. And if they had, it's just, I don't know why I get all excited emotional about this, but anyway, if they had eaten, that still, if anybody had eaten it, they could have died. And so even though that was a disaster, it was a miracle disaster. And God kept his angels there and protected them from eating that stew. And when I read this story, involved, of course, and when I read this story, I thought, you know, so many times awful things happen to us, and we just like, why did this happen to me? Why did my building catch on fire? Why did these things happen to me? Why, I don't understand, you know, I pay my tithe, I go to church, I help, I do everything I can. Why did these things happen? But this is a sinful world that we live in. And when these things happen, what do we need to do? What do we need to do? We need to keep our eyes fixed on Jesus and know that he is in control. And things don't just happen willy-nilly. It might seem like it, but they don't. And God uses these things to bring us closer to him and to learn how to trust him more. And that sometimes we get caught up in our little pity parties. Me, myself, if I start thinking about myself, I'm like, oh, poor me. Oh. But when I start looking at Jesus and what I can do for him, then I can just let it go. Let it go and let God handle it. And so that's the story. And if anything ever happens to you, and it will, just think of the mushroom stew, okay? Think of the mushroom stew. All right. Would you like to pray, Brianna? No? Okay. Oh. Thank you so much, dear Jesus, for each person who's here, for Brianna, and for her grandpa. And thank you, Lord, for your love for us, and for showing us in so many different ways how much you love us and care for us and what happens to us in our daily lives. And what happens to us might seem trivial to someone else, but it's a disaster in our lives, and we know that we can just turn it over to you and look to you for love and guidance, and you will get us through. Thank you so much for the Sabbath and for all of your blessings. In Jesus' name, amen.